I'm Jason Shep of Ferguson Roofing. Ferguson Roofing is a business partner with the Heartland Chapter of the Community Associations Institute. And today I'll be talking about the difference between an insurance claim and a non-insurance claim when having roof work done. More specifically, the differences in the bidding process. Roofing has become synonymous with insurance. These days, there's the expectation, both through habits of insurance companies and of consumers, that if roofing work is going to get done, it's going to get done through an insurance claim. And the bidding process is different. First of all, the insurance company is going to be setting the price. Now, we have to do our due diligence to make sure that price is fair and at market rate. That can be done through utilizing a consultant, or it can be done utilizing a trusted contractor that you know will work on your behalf to make sure that the claim is handled properly. But there's no longer need to get multiple bids. The old adage of get three bids, you can kind of throw that out the window. Now, you still want to vet your contractors, and looking at multiple contractors is appropriate, but actually basing your decision on price is no longer relevant because the insurance claim is going to set the price itself. Now, right there is a different mindset, and that's why it's so important to make sure that you educate the board. Now, this should be an ongoing practice anyway, but particularly in a time of a catastrophe and a large-scale loss like a roofing claim in a condominium association or an HOA, what qualifies that? You want to make sure that the board is educated. Now, in our industry, we do what's called a pre-construction meeting, and that essentially is getting all the key decision makers and any relevant advisors or experts around the table at the onset of the event to make sure that things are getting handled correctly and all the right questions are asked. I'd encourage the same thing to be done with the board. Now, in doing that, we can make sure that we understand all the differences of the insurance claim process versus the regular bid process, because there are going to be some paradigm shifts and people are going to typically want to default to conventional wisdom, and that may not necessarily be the best course of action. In the event of a large-scale insurance claim, the insurance companies know that it takes a lot of time to get everything resolved properly. And there's extensions to the normal claim resolution, so there is no reason to rush. Typically, in the event of hail damage specifically, there is no immediate need to get the work done. Hail presents a long-term damage to the shingles. Typically, it's not an immediate situation. If your roof is leaking after a hailstorm, usually it's because of the associated wind-driven rain events or something like that, not because of the hail. So there's plenty of time to relax and make good strategic decisions. Now, there are times where a storm event could include high winds. We have had tornadoes more common in this area, and that does create some urgency that you do need to get repairs done immediately to make sure that the homes are properly protected. Now, even with that increased sense of urgency, again, we don't want to rush. Just grabbing the first contractor who's willing to jump up on a roof and offer their assistance to get you in the dry may not always be the best thing. We still need to make sure that that contractor meets the basic qualifications of being properly insured, isn't asking that a questionable contract gets signed. They still need to be vetted. Rushing sometimes can actually create bigger issues where if the wrong contractor is involved with the project, that could create undue and inappropriate invoices. It can complicate the insurance reconciliation and could oftentimes lead to having a lien on the facility, which is not a good thing. So even though we act fast in those situations, we still want to act smart. Reference the video that I did last year regarding how to vet a contractor. Follow those steps so that you can make good decisions on what relationships that you already have established. So in the event of a catastrophe, you already have the proper resources ready. Remember that with an insurance claim, the bidding process is a lot different. So make sure that you do your due diligence and think outside the box. For more information, please visit the CAI website, and you can learn a lot more about this and many other topics. My name is Jason Shupp with Ferguson Roofing. Thank you very much.